Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about Coulomb's law. Coulomb is the name of a scientist who deduced an expression in between the expression for the force which is existing in between the two point charges. Okay. His name is Coulomb. In 1786 he deduced this expression, okay, to find out the force exerted by the one charge upon the other charge. Okay. Such type of relations are deduced or discovered by the scientist Coulomb. Okay, let us see the two point charges. One is Q1 and another one is Q2. Q1 is also a positive charge and Q2 is also a positive charge. These are all separated by a distance small r. Okay, according to the Coulomb's law, the force on the point charge Q2 exerted by the another point charge Q1. Understand? Now the charge Q1 is going to exert a force on Q2. In reverse, the charge Q2 will exert a force on Q1. Okay. First, we shall discuss the Coulomb's law. Why they have deduced the equation number 1.2. The explanation is given here, but we shall discuss it now itself. Okay, equation 1.2, how they have written like that means the force between the two point charges, that may be attractive force or repulsive force. If the charges are opposite charges, means there may be attractive force. If the charges are same charges, means there may be a repulsive force. Whatever be the force, okay, let us calculate the magnitude of the force or the value of the force. Okay, first they have found F21. F21 means what is the force on charge 2 by 1. That's why they have written F vector 21. Understand the meaning of F21. F21 is nothing but the force exerted by the first charge upon the second charge. That's why we put in suffix first 2, then 1. Okay. What is the first? 2 is the first one. Okay. So from that we can conclude that charge Q1 is going to exert a force on the charge 2. That's why we have written 2 first. Okay, who exerts a force? Q1 exerts a force. That's why we have written 1 after the 2. உங்களுக்கு புரிஞ்சிருக்கும்னு நினைக்கிறேன். F21 னு ஏன் எழுதுறாங்கன்னா, ஒன்றாவது சார்ஜ் ரெண்டாவது சார்ஜ் மேலே எவ்வளோ ஃபோர்ஸ் எக்ஸர்ட் பண்ணுது, இல்லை ரெண்டாவது சார்ஜ் எவ்வளோ ஃபோர்ஸை ஒன்றாவது சார்ஜினால் எக்ஸர்ட் பண்ணுது, எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் பண்ணுது, அதுக்காக தான் F21 எழுதுறோம். ஓகே, வாட் இஸ் த வேல்யூ இஃப் யூ கால்குலேட் த ஃபோர்ஸ் பிட்வீன் தீஸ் டூ சார்ஜஸ், மீன்ஸ் கே இன்டூ K1 K2 டிவைட் பை ஆர் ஸ்கொயர் இன்டூ R12 கேப். How they have deduced this equation means the force between the two positive charges or two negative charges, okay, is directly proportional to the magnitude of the charge 1 and charge 2. The product of magnitude of the charge 1 and charge 2. Okay. The rendu charges ku adoda quantity, adoda magnitude irukku illaya, adoda perukku thogai ku nirvigithil irukum. Ipa k1 irukku, k2 irukku, okay va, adu rendu multiply pandrom, adanal dhaan k1 k2. Appo f ngra force edhai poruthu irukum appadina, it is directly proportional to the product of the two charges k1 and k2. Okay, it is also inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them, however they have separated in a distance of r. Okay, suppose if we square the r, means r square. So the force will be inversely proportional to the distance. If the distance increases, the force decreases. If the distance decreases, the force will increase. So in such a way we can express that the force is inversely proportional to the distance between them. That's why they have put r square in the denominator. Okay, if any quantity is in denominator, means it is inversely proportional. Okay, then what is mean by R12 cap? R12 cap, it is a unit vector. Okay, unit vector means what? A force is acting from K1 to K2. It denotes the direction. R12 cap means it denotes the direction in which way the force is existing. Okay, so that they have put R cap, R12 cap. Okay, what is K? Here k is nothing but a proportionality constant. Okay, instead of putting k, first we should write f to 1 is proportional to, proportionality symbol should be there. Okay, f to 1 is proportional to k1 k2 divided by r square r12 cap. Okay, in order to remove the proportionality symbol, let us put equation, and we should also put a constant known as k. Okay, that's why they have removed the proportionality symbol and they put equation symbol, and in addition to that, k also introduced. K is nothing but the proportionality constant. Okay, so this is the Coulomb's law. What are all the important aspects of Coulomb's law means? In the first point, they have explained what I have explained earlierly in the equation number 1.2. While I am explaining equation number 1.2, how they have deduced, how they have written this equation, the definition is the first point. Okay, what is the definition? Coulomb's law states that electrostatic force between the two charges is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of the two point charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Okay, I have already told there itself. Okay, let us leave the first point. Okay, then second point. Okay, the force on the charge Q2 exerted by the charge Q1 always lies along the line joining the two charges. Okay, I have already told you that while I am explaining the unit vector. Okay, what is the force direction? The force exerted by the Q2 and by Q1. Okay, what is the line? The force on the charge Q2 is exerted by the charge Q1. Q2 ங்கிற சார்ஜ் எவ்வளோ ஃபோர்ஸை எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் பண்ணுது? கே ஒன்றுனால. ஓகேவா, அது வந்து அந்த ஃபோர்ஸோட லைன், அந்த ஃபோர்ஸோட டைரெக்ஷன் எப்படி இருக்கும் அப்படின்னு சொன்னால், எந்த லைனில் இருக்கும், எங்கே இருக்கும் அப்படின்னு சொன்னால், இந்த ரெண்டு பாயிண்ட் சார்ஜஸும் ஜாயின் பண்ணுற ஒரு லைன் இருக்குது இல்லை, அந்த லைன் வழியாக இருக்கும். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், அந்த ஃபோர்ஸோட டைரெக்ஷன் எப்படி இருக்குன்னா, இந்த ரெண்டு பாயிண்ட் சார்ஜஸும் ஜாயின் பண்ணுற அந்த லைன் வழியாக இருக்கும். ஓகே, லைக்வைஸ் த ஃபோர்ஸ் ஆன் த சார்ஜ் கே ஒன். So, okay, in reverse, first we have discussed about the charge experienced by the Q2 by Q1. The charge experienced by the Q2 charge, okay, due to the first charge Q1. Now, let us discuss about what is the charge experienced by the Q1 due to Q2. Okay, here also the unit vector will be minus R12 cap. Okay. First we have put R12 cap only because this is in forward direction and here it is a reverse direction, that's why we have put a minus symbol here. Okay, in third point they have deduced the value of k. What is the value of k? What is mean by k? K is nothing but the proportionality constant, proportionality constant k. How can we derive the value of k? Means we can calculate k is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay, and its value they have deduced, they have calculated already, whose value is 9 into 10 to the power of 9 Newton meter square Coulomb power minus 2. Okay, this is the important value and this is the important unit. Okay, here the epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space or in vacuum. Okay, what is mean by permittivity? Suppose if any medium is there, okay, air medium or liquid medium, whatever it may be, any medium. Suppose the ability of the electric field lines or magnetic field lines or whatever may be the field, okay, how the field lines can enter into the medium, the medium itself will exist some resistive force. Okay, that depends upon the medium, that's why we have called it as the permeability, utpugathiran, uduruthiran. Okay, permittivity, epsilon naught is nothing but the permittivity. Okay, whose value can be calculated in the above equation? If we bring the epsilon naught into the left hand side and let us bring the k into the denominator. Okay, whose value we have to find out means we can change the formula as we like it. Okay, so from the above formula, k is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, whose value is 9 into 10 to the power of 9. Okay, if we have to find out the epsilon naught value, means we shall bring the k into the denominator. Okay, then whose value is calculated 8.85 into 10 to the power of minus 2 coulomb square newton power minus 1 meter power minus 2. Okay, next, fourth point. The magnitude of the electrostatic force between the two charges, each of 1 coulomb and are separated by a distance 1 meter. Okay, here we have discussed about, we have two charges. It has been separated by means of some distance. Suppose the magnitude of the each charges is 1 coulomb and 1 coulomb. If they are separated by a distance of 1 meter, okay, then what is the force between them? Okay, what is the formula here in the third point? Not third point, in the equation number 1.2. Okay, here K1 is also 1 coulomb, K2 is also 1 coulomb. R is nothing but 1.